An American investment banker was at the pier of a small coastal Mexican village when a small boat with just one fisherman docked. Inside the small boat were several large yellowfin tuna. The American complimented the Mexican on the quality of his fish and asked how long it took to catch them. The Mexican replied, "Only a little while." The American then asked why didn't he stay out longer and catch more fish. The Mexican said he had enough to support his family's immediate needs. The American then asked, "But what do you do with the rest of your time?" The Mexican fisherman said, "I sleep late, fish a little, play with my children, take siestas with my wife, and stroll into the village each evening where I sip wine and play guitar with my amigos. I have a full and busy life." The American scoffed, "I'm a Harvard MBA and could help you. You should spend more time fishing and with the proceeds buy a bigger boat. With the proceeds from the bigger boat, you could buy several boats. Eventually, you would have a fleet of fishing boats. Instead of selling your catch to a middleman, you would sell directly to the processor, eventually opening your own cannery. You would control the product, processing, and distribution. You would need to leave this small coastal fishing village and move to Mexico City, then LA, and eventually New York City, where you would run your expanding enterprise." The Mexican fisherman asked, "But how long would this all take?" To which the American replied, 15 to 20 years. "But what then?" asked the Mexican. The American laughed and said, "That's the best part. When the time is right, you would announce an IPO and sell your company stock to the public and become very rich. You would make millions." "Millions," said the Mexican, "and then what?" The American said, "Then you would retire. Move to a small coastal fishing village where you would sleep late, fish a little, play with your kids, take siestas with your wife and stroll to the village in the evenings where you could sip wine and play guitar with your amigos." So what's the moral of the story here? Well, we always think that in order to live good, we first have to make a lot of money. We first have to reach success. But that's not the point. Success is what you make of life, and it can be as successful as how you want it to be. You see, we always aim for the next mountaintop, and the one after that, and the next one, and so on. When you are not satisfied with your life as it is now, you will never be. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't try to work hard to achieve something, or that you shouldn't have a goal in mind. Rather, I'm saying that you should be prepared that the mountaintop is probably not high enough when you're there. That you'll want the next one. So instead of chasing and chasing the next top, look at where you are now. Look at what you can do with your life that makes you happy. How much do you already have? The solution is that you need to be present and start living life right now. Not living life as in smoking weed, going to parties, etc. But actually live it. Enjoy the work you do. Enjoy the free time that you spend with your friends, family, or maybe even your girlfriend. Enjoy the free time when you're able to read a book. When you take a walk through the forest, hear the birds chirping, and feel the wind in your face. How? Well, I can guide you. Just click the first link in the description for an introduction call. Well, it's your life. Decide it for yourself. Stay stoic.